Good morning, all of you. Today I am going to discuss about the engineering furloughs. Here, the engineering furloughs are also called as a conic sections. Why we call it as a conic section? Here, when you are taking the cone, it is going to cut shape in a different sections. The conic sections will be formed. You can see there are three different types of the engineering furloughs or the conic sections. The first one is ellipse and the parabola, and third one is hyperbola. Here this is the curve I take, the cone I take in. The cone is cut by like this. This is the section plane. The section plane is passing through the generators. Here all these are the different types of the generators. The generators are cut by this section. After cutting this, the cone will be cutting into like this. Here we remove the top portion and remaining bottom portion is this one. This is nothing but an ellipse. Likewise here, this is another cone I taken, and if I cut the cone like this, that is parallel to the generator. Here this is the section plane passing through the end generators. Parallel to this end generator, then remaining it forms as a just parabola. This you can see the shape of the cone. After cutting section, this portion I removed and the remaining portion is this one. Then this is called as a parabola. Then the hyperbola is formed. The section plane is passing through the parallel to the axis of a cone. Then if I remove this portion, the remaining portion is looks like a hyperbola. So like this, here the cones will be formed. That's why we call it as a conic sections. Here, from the mathematics point of view also, we know that the eccentricity value for an ellipse, parabola and a hyperbola. For an eccentricity value for an ellipse is E is less than 1 and E is equal to 1 for parabola and E is greater than 1 for the hyperbola. Now, we can see the construction of the ellipse by using concentric circle method. So this is the problem here. Draw the ellipse by concentric circle method. By using the concentric circle method, we are going to draw the ellipse. Here, the major axis of the ellipse is given 100 mm and the minor axis of the ellipse is 70 mm given. So with these two values, I am going to draw the major axis. The AB is the major axis and CD is the minor axis. So with this, I am going to construct in the two circles by using the major axis and also the minor axis. So this is the circle with the length of a minor axis, that is 70 mm length. And the another circle, this is the length I take as a major axis, that is 100 mm length. Then after that, this entire two circles I divide it into a 12 number of equal parts. So this is the 12 number of parts. Then after that, I am giving the numbers for this one. Here, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, like that I am giving the numbers. Then similarly, for minor axis circle also, I am giving the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, like this. After that, we need to draw the lines from the major axis. You need to draw the lines from the major axis vertically downward or the upward direction. But the case is inside the circle we need to draw. Right? Again I am telling you, draw the vertical lines either upward or the downward direction from the major axis circle. See, this is the vertical line we can draw in the inside the major axis circle. This is the vertically downward. Similarly, this is another line. Similarly, this is the vertically downward line. All these lines are inside the major axis circle. Then, so this is another line, vertically upward direction inside the major axis. So like this, here all the lines we completed. Then, and one more line we need to draw, that is horizontal lines from the minor axis circle horizontally either outside, maybe right side or the left side. So see, this is the horizontal line we drawn from the minor axis circle horizontally to the outward direction. So So like that, this is another line. So if you draw the all the lines from the minor axis, all the lines will go to meet. So if you see, this is the point, this is another point, like all the points. If you join all these points, an ellipse will be formed. This is the different points. See, starting with the major axis from A, then second point, third point, like this. And the fourth point is on the minor axis circuit at a point C. Then like that, if you join all these points, an ellipse will be formed in the concentric circle method. So this is nothing but a ellipse in the concentric circle method. Next, we can see the ellipse by rectangle method. In this also, the same problem I taken. Here, the major axis again 100 mm and the minor axis is 70 mm. Then, here, with the major axis length 100 mm, I draw the major axis AB, then minor axis CD, again it is a 70 mm. And after that, by using the major axis length and the minor axis length, I am going to creating a one rectangle box. So this is the rectangle box. The name itself, it indicates this is the rectangle method. By using the major axis and the minor axis, I constructed the rectangle box. Then after that, here I taken the quarter part of the rectangle, then that vertically I divided into four parts. Four are the equal parts. Then again I taken the given the numbers 1, 2, 3. Then for this quarter part, horizontally from A to this O, again I divided into same number of equal parts. All parts are equal. You give the numbers also. Same 1, 2, 3, 4. Like from A to upward direction, from A to horizontally right side 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, the lines you need to draw from the point D to 1, 2, 3. Similarly, we need to draw the lines from the point C through the point 1 up to the point 1 on the vertically. Again, from the C 2 to again 2 up to. Like that, here the three lines I draw. Then where the three these lines are meeting, I got the three different points. 1, 2, 3. If I draw the curve from A to this point, up to this point, and up to end, so up to D, now the quarter part of the ellipse will be completed. So these are the different points I need to join for getting the ellipse. So this is the same process I am going to repeat it remaining three portions also, then I can get the complete ellipse by using the rectangle method. The same process, whatever the process I completed here, the same process I am going to repeat. Then I can get the complete rectangular method. So this is the ellipse by using the rectangle method. Now we can see the oblong method. Ellipse by using the oblong method. Here, for the oblong method, the extra information we require, that is inclination. Again the problem, draw parabola of 100 mm, major axis is given 100 mm length and the minor axis 70 mm long, and also the inclination is 75 mm is given. So this is the parabola. What is the difference between this and previous one? Only instead of previous one, it is a vertical line, but it is a 75 degrees angle line. So now we call it as a, this is a parabola, sorry, ellipse. The same process we are going to follow for this method also. Same, vertical line is divided into four number of equal parts, and the horizontal line again we divided into four number of equal parts. The numbers and the line is joining from D to 1, D to 2, like that from C to 1, the same process. Only the difference is angle. Minor axis line, you need to make it as a 75 degrees. That is the only difference. Right. This is the ellipse by using the oblong method. Right. Now, arcs of circle method. answer circle method. Here the problem is major axis and minor axis are given 100 mm and 70 mm long. We draw the ellipse by using the arcs of circle method. The name itself, it indicates we need to draw the different arcs. By joining this, we can construct an ellipse. Here, same, major axis is AB and the minor axis is CD. Then, the intersection of major axis and the minor axis is point O. Then, here, the line I drawn from the point C to here. This is for identification of the foci points F1 and F2. How can I draw this line? I need to take the distance of AO and C as a center. If I cut the line AO, then this is the point F1. Similarly, the distance of AO I taken from the C, if I cut this OB line, then I can get the F2 point. So these two are the foci points F1 and F2. Now, after that, here, this is the points, between the F1 and O, I want to take the two or three points that must not be equal. Here, four points I taken. Then, this is the line. Here, I taken the A1 as a radius, F1 as a center, I draw the arc or the line. Similarly, B2 F1 as a radius and F2 as a center, if I cut the arc or if I draw the line, I can get the point. Then from A2, I need to take the radius and F1 as a center, I need to draw the line. This is the line I taken from A to 2. Then one more line from F2 here, the further radius is B to 2. So like that here, this is the same for A to 3 and A to 4. If I draw remaining 4 points, I am going to get. So these are the 4 points. If I join the from A to all these points up to C, then the quarter part of the ellipse I am going to get in. So P1, P2, P3 and P4. If I join the line, this is a curve, it is a quarter part of the ellipse by using the arcs of circle method. The same procedure we can repeat for the remaining cells, so we can get the complete ellipse. Same procedure we need to complete. Thank you.